Welcome back to the channel. I want to show you guys a new way to review your source footage that's been added to the edit page in Resolve 20. If you don't see a dual screen viewer, click this box on the upper right here with the two square boxes. This will give you your timeline on the right and your source on the left. And normally when you're clicking through footage, you would add your clip over here, drop it in. You can actually double click it. You'd make an in and an out and add it down into your timeline. And one thing I like to do, if I have like an A cam, a B cam, or certain locations, I'll make a timeline and string all those clips out into one timeline. So let's say we did that with this 25 FPS timeline. You can grab a clip from here and copy it, and then go back to your other timeline and paste it in here. One way of working, you can also use stack timelines. If we go down here underneath this preview monitor, you can click this timeline options box, and the first option is display stack timelines. If you have that available, this will give you these tabs like we have here. And if you click this drop down arrow, it'll list any of the timelines you've created right here. Now, another way you can do this is with stack timelines right here on the right next to the mixer. Click this box and you'll get a secondary timeline. And then you can select it down from here. This is a way I used to work quite a bit. So now I have this timeline down below. I could click and copy a clip and then go back to my main edit up here and insert a shot there. Here's a new way you can do this that they just added in Resolve 20. We have a few more icons above this preview monitor. Second one here, we now have a source tape viewer. So if you click on a folder, you can see we have all these clips in here, and they're now sorted by these little white tick marks. And if you use your up and down arrows, it'll cycle through each of your clips. You can still fast forward and play. You can make in and outs, and you can edit this down into your timeline. So let's say we wanted to add this shot here. We could forward it F10. It'll append it down to the timeline. We can hit Q, and that gives us control of our timeline. And then we can hit Q and get back to our source tape all with one quick little button and go through our footage. Also from the cut page, there's a little icon here called Fast Review. If you click that, it'll speed through footage. And if it's a longer clip, it'll go faster. And until it sees different on-screen action, it'll slow down when you get a bunch of successive clips. This is another good way of going through all your footage. And lastly, the third option is your timeline viewer. So just like the timeline options we had here in this drop-down menu, you can now open these timelines right up in your source viewer, and it kind of bounces back and forth automatically. So if we open up the 25 FPS timeline, so this would have been the one I was working on, we can right-click that and say Find Timeline in Media Pool. Grab this timeline, right click, and we now have a new option, open in timeline with source viewer. If I click that, you're going to see it turns blue and our playhead turns blue. So it kind of opens it on a new tab, but it's giving you viewer access. So now if we go back to our main edit, we're going to keep this timeline on the left and we can navigate through, do the in and out, and click one click back to our main edit. And we can use the Q button to do that. So the red playhead is our main edit, our main timeline, and the blue is like whatever our preview is. And that's a few different ways you can now review your sources without having to go through the individual clips or make timelines on your own. You can just use the whole folder structure. You can highlight all the folders and review all your media in one fell swoop if that's how you want to do it. All right, that's all I wanted to show you guys on this video. If you got a video topic you want me to take a stab at, leave it down below. And if you want some more tips, check out the video right above me, and I'll see you guys on the next video.